Sairam students, welcome back. Today we are going to learn EVS 1 Geography, 17th chapter, Clothes are Necessity. But before that, let's take a short recap. What we had learned in our previous session, we had learned EVS 2 History, 8th chapter, Beginning of Settled Life, Part 2. In it, we had learned community life based on mutual cooperation, then structure of houses, village, settlement, kinship and family. And today we are going to start with our chapter. The first point, likings for clothes. Students, likings for clothes means desire for clothes. Okay, we may find that the number of clothes we wish to have is rather large. This means, though we have clothes, we feel that we should buy more or we like to purchase more clothes. Okay, we like to have new clothes, whatever we have, but we like to have new clothes. Okay, so the next, need and greed for clothes. Wanting clothes and really needing them are different things. Wanting things when we do not need them is simply desire, not necessity. Means wanting and needing both are different from each other. Wanting clothes and really needing them both are different things. Wanting things when we do not need them is simply a desire. Okay. Not just a necessity. Necessity means when it is really required is known as necessity. Next, students, this is a picture of a handloom. So what is handloom? Handloom means any loom other than the power loom and includes any hybrid looms on which at least one process for weaving require manual intervention or human energy for production. Okay, so the person here is weaving a cloth. So you know, silk saris are being made on handloom, even blankets are made on handloom. Okay, now the next, students. Now, what is this? This is a picture of a charkha. Charkha means spinning wheel. Yes. Now, do you know Gandhiji initiated the Swadeshi movement by taking the charkha and encouraging the Indians to spin their own clothes? Okay. The charkha became a symbol of self-sufficiency and freedom. So much so that the first Indian flag designed had the charkha in the middle, which was later replaced by the Ashoka Chakra. Okay, now the next, advertisements and desire for clothes. We see many advertisements on TV, hoardings, etc. and we are attracted towards the clothes shown in them. This attraction can turn into greed. Okay, greed means desire. So we see many advertisements on TVs. Okay, and even when we go outside, we see hoardings and we are attracted towards the clothes shown in them because they are so bright in colors and so beautifully dressed, so we get attracted to it. This attraction can turn into greed, means desire for clothes. Okay, next point, textile industry centers in Maharashtra. Paithani of Paithan and Yavla, Himru shawls from Aurangabad, bed sheets and bed spreads from Solapur, handloom and power loom cloth from Itzalkaranji, etc. So students, this are the textile industry centers in Maharashtra. Okay, Paithani of Paithan and Yevla, Himru shawls from Aurangabad, bed sheets and bedspread from Solapur, handloom and power loom cloths from
Ichal Karanji.
Okay, next. Now we are going to read map of Maharashtra state, important textile industries. Okay, so this is the direction of the map. North, towards your head. South, towards your toes. East, to your right hand side. And west, to your left hand side. Okay, then next is index given here. First symbol is of cloth from
Ichal Karanji.
Second is bed sheets from Solapur. Third is Himru shawl. Fourth is Yevla sari. And next is Paithani saris. Okay. And now we are going to find those on the map. First, we are going to find clothes from
Ichal Karanji.
So, come on. Find where is it?
Ichal Karanji.
You can see the symbol of
Ichal Karanji.
Here, it is shown. Okay. It's located in Kolhapur. Right? Then the next is bed sheet. So we are going to find the second one, bed sheet from Solapur. Found? Okay. Next is Himru shawl. See here. Aurangabad. Himru shawl in Aurangabad. Next is Yevla sari. So Yevla sari you can find here, Nasik. Okay, and the last one is Paithani from Paithan. So where is that? Here, it's in Aurangabad. Okay, now the next point is diversity in clothes in India. A variety of fabrics and costumes have come into use due to the diverse climatic conditions in different parts of the country. With better transport facilities, they have become available in all places. This diversity in clothes is a part of the diversity in our country. Okay, this means students, a variety of fabrics and costumes have come into use due to the diverse climatic conditions in different parts of the country. Means from the different parts of the country, people use different types of clothes according to the climatic condition over there. So with the better transport facilities, they have become available in all places. Means if I like to wear a Kashmiri suit in Mumbai, I can, because of the transport facility, because better transport facility is there. And anywhere from any place we can order the things and it will be available for us within few time. Okay, this diversity in cloth is a part of diversity in our country. Now the next is changes in clothing due to traditions and in the course of time. During the evolution of man, his body went through many changes. One of the changes was the reduction in the amount of body hair. As a result, he began to need protection from the elements in certain weather conditions. Thus arose the need for cloth. This means students, during the evolution of man, his body went through many changes. Many changes had been taken place in his body. So one of the change was the reduction of body hair. Okay. As a result, he began to need protection from the elements in certain weather condition. As for example, if it is cold, so he need some furry or warm clothes in the cold season. Then in the hot season, he needed cotton clothes, or you can say airy clothes. Okay. And in the rainy season, he needed the clothes which can protect him from the water, means water resistant clothes. Okay. So as a result, he began to need protection from the elements in certain weather conditions. Thus arose the need for clothes. Okay. Next, we can see a variety in the clothes used through the ages. In prehistoric times, man did not wear clothes. Later, he began using the bark and leaves of trees. After that, he began to hunt and used the skins of the animals he had killed. In prehistoric time, man did not wear clothes because his body had a large amount of body hairs. But gradually, the hairs started reducing from the body, and later he began using the bark and leaves of trees. Then he began to hunt and use the skins of the animals he had killed. Okay, so in this way we can see a variety in clothes used through the ages. Okay, after he learned to make yarn from materials like cotton wool, he began to use cotton clothes in a variety of ways. You will see this progression in the picture given below. So after he learned to make yarns from the materials like cotton wool, he began to use cotton clothes in variety of ways. So now we will see the picture. Our clothing changed with time. See, in the ancient time, man had plenty of body hairs, so he didn't used to wear clothes on his body. After that, he started using animal skin, then bark of the tree, leaves of the tree. After that, he started preparing yarn from the thread, cotton thread. Then after that, man started stitching the clothes with the hands, like you can see kurta and dhoti. And today the new technological man, or the modern man you can say, wears shorts and pants. So this is the progress of the man in clothing. Now the next, need for giving priority to needs and not desire. Now we should give priority to our needs and not the desire. See, nature has given us enough to fulfill everyone's need. However, nature cannot quench man's greed. Man must give priority to his needs and not desires. Only then will nature be able to take care of us all. Okay, this means students, nature cannot quench man's greed or desire, you can say. But nature has given us enough to fulfill everyone's need. Man must give priority to his needs and not his desire, and then only nature will be able to take care of us all. Okay. Next, Mumbai, an important hub for financial activity in India. Mumbai was famous worldwide for its textile mills. The humid weather on the island facilitates the manufacture of the long thread for making cloth. That is why Mumbai became a big center of textile industry. Students, because of our humid weather on the island facilitates the manufacture of the long thread for making clothes. Mumbai was famous worldwide for its textile mills, and that is why Mumbai became a big center of textile industry. Okay. The flourishing cloth industry attracted workers from all over the country who came and settled here. From then on, Mumbai became an important hub for financial capital activity in India. The flourishing cloth industry attracted workers from all over the country who came and settled here. From then on, Mumbai became an important hub for financial activity in India. This means students from all over the world, the workers started coming to Mumbai. Yes, and they came and settled here because of the flourishing cloth industry. They attracted workers from all over the country. From then on, Mumbai became an important hub, means center, for financial activity in India. Okay. What we have learned today? We have learned likings for clothes, need and greed for clothes, advertisements and desire for clothes, textile industry centers in Maharashtra, diversity in clothes in India, changes in clothes due to traditions and in the course of time, need for giving priority to needs and not desire, Mumbai an important hub for financial activity in India. Next activity, question first, match the following. Question is given and four options are given. You are going to choose the right option. First is Solapur. A. Sari. B. Bedsheet. C. Curtain. D. Shawl. Solapur is famous for bedsheet. Yes. Next. Second is Paithan. Paithan is famous for A. Sari. B. Bedsheet. C. Curtain. D. Shawl. And your answer is A. Sari. Paithan is famous for Paithani sarees. Third, Aurangabad. A. Sari. B. Bedsheet. C. Curtain. D. Shawl. And the answer is shawl. D. Shawl. Means Aurangabad is famous for its shawl. Okay. That's all for today. Sai Ram. Thank you.